Guys, welcome to our YouTube channel Shift and Throttle. Today we are going to present you with an scooty that is selling like hotcakes ever since it was launched in India, since its first generation. Today we are going to review the Honda Activa 5th generation. Yes, we know that the Honda Activa 6th generation has been launched, but we are going to today tell you about the key differences between the BS4 and the BS6 version of this scooty. And should you still consider it or buy it, and is it still worth it in 2020? And as it was launched in 2018, you can see the condition of this scooty is impeccable and it has not seen any bad days ever since it was bought by the owner. Now talking about the design of this scooty. The design of the scooty has almost remained unchanged since the inception of the Honda Activa first generation. The design has almost seen a very subtle change, and in the 5G version they only introduced a LED headlight, not anything else. They only introduced telescopic suspension now in the 6G version and external fuel cap also in the 6G version, not in the 5G version, which was a bit of a disappointment when it was launched back in 2018. But other than that, the design looks very professional and elegant, and you can go to office and school at the same time with this scooty and you will not feel out of place anytime soon. Now talking about the engine of this scooty. This scooty is powered by a 110cc air-cooled 4-stroke 2-valve motor which produces 9 bhp of power at 7500 rpm and 8 Newton meters of torque at 5500 rpm. In the BS6 avatar, the power has gone down marginally at 8.79 bhp at 8000 rpm and 7.79 Newton meters of torque at 5500 rpm. But you will not feel the difference in BS6 and BS4 at all, because they have cleverly increased the peak power at 8000 rpm instead of 7500 rpm. So it delivers power elegantly at all the levels, and it will do 80 to 90 km per hour all day easily. It will struggle to do triple digit speed as it is only a 110cc scooty. Talking about the exhaust note of this scooty. The exhaust note of this scooty is not very bassy, but it is very smooth, and you can hear it now. Now talking about the tires and brake on this scooty. The tires on this scooty are 10-inch 90x100 section tire at both front and rear, and in the braking department it does not offer any disc brake, but it offers 130mm drum brakes at both front and rear, and also offers combi braking system or CBS, which Honda proudly claims that is better than ABS for scooties. Talking about the digital meter of this scooty. It offers you a part analog and part digital instrument console, and in the analog console it offers you the speed of the scooty, and in the digital console it offers you all the important information such as time, your total trip, and how much fuel does your scooty has. And it also has a trip meter which will offer you information about your last trip and how much kilometer have you covered recently. Now talking about the boot size capacity of this scooty. The boot size capacity of this scooty is 14 liters, and it can carry a full face helmet very easily, which is a very big plus point for this scooty and is a major selling point for Activa. And talking about the fuel tank capacity of this scooty. The fuel tank capacity of this scooty is 5.4 liters, which is less but respectable for a scooty this size, as it offers a mileage of 45 kilometers to the liter. But in real world, when you drive a bit fast or harshly, it will give deliver your order mileage of 25 to 30 kilometers to the liter. Now talking about some of the pros of the scooty. The first and major pro is the Honda service network. As the Honda service network is widely spread all across India, so they sell the scooties like hot cakes when it is launched, even without changes. And this scooty also offers you a lot of confidence, as you are getting a very nice service network and also get a very good mileage according to the size of this scooty, as it offers you a 45 kilometers to the liter mileage. So these are the basic two cons which the consumer looks for. And also the third con is the space this scooty offers, as this scooty offers you a lot of space and you can easily carry a full size battery or even an inverter with it. Now talking about some of the disappointment of this scooty. The first and major disappointment of the scooty when it was launched was that it only offered you a LED headlight as a change from Activa 4G to 5G and a BS4 engine, and nothing else was changed. And it didn't even have a telescopic suspension or external fuel cap. So for the conclusion or the verdict of this scooty, as you know, this scooty is offered by Honda, so you are getting an excellent service network. So finally, should you ignore it, consider it, shortlist it, or go ahead and directly buy it? I think you should definitely shortlist it, as you are getting a lot of competition these days, even from TVS and Bajaj, as they are offering very good alternatives. But if you are a Honda fanboy, then this is the best scooty for you, and you will feel very proud to own this.